And I'm going back to the newspapers because I spoke earlier about rumours in The Guardian, what's happening at different universities in the UK. But on page 2 of the Echo, councillors advised to give homes and hotel scheme the green light. And this is Harlequins, or what was Harlequins, what's now going to be co-living. And it originally was student accommodation, but now it's a mix. And there's various things about this. What the advice seems to be, there really wasn't any choice, because there wasn't enough alternative over the next 5 years, and there wasn't a plan that was in date. There's various reasons why refusing planning permission would have been very difficult. But the people who commented, 375 of 379 people who commented objected, and then the various reasons, which you only get towards the end, included traffic impacts, overspill parking, and concerns the co-living block will be used as student accommodation. So I think that's still an issue, and I just don't know any sort of study or research about what the consequence of online learning will be for the nature of the campus over the next 20, 30 years, however long you think these buildings will stay up for. And I don't think that's not been addressed. It's not been addressed in Exeter or anywhere, as far as I can tell. So going back to the Guardian again, I don't think I did read this out before. A Department of Education spokesperson said universities are ultimately autonomous and responsible for their own staffing decisions, but we expect them to make sure staff are as safe as possible. So that's their take on move online now hashtag and all the other concerns that the staff unions do have. But I think it's just seems to be the same with the student accommodation, that it's a boom that's been going on in the UK for a while, but whether it continues, I'm not sure. And it just seems very strange that there's doesn't seem to be any reporting on it. There's no scenario stats or anything like that about the numbers of students that are expected to be on campus or travelling internationally or studying online or what they're going to be doing. The other thing I wanted to mention, there's a book by Donald Clark called Artificial Intelligence for Learning, and this is available. Waterstones in Exeter can get hold of it. And I mentioned that because the other book that I've been talking about, the Online Manifesto for Learning, the Manifesto for Teaching Online, the Edinburgh book, that seems to be out of print. MIT Press publish it, but Waterstones in Exeter can't get hold of it. Maybe it's proved very, very popular. But this book, I think, is also very, very interesting. But it's coming from a sort of vocational learning end of things as well. There's quite a lot about universities, and Donald Clark on Twitter is very clear what he thinks about the campus moving online and that sort of thing. But there's a very interesting diagram, page 156, if you can get hold of a copy, about formal and informal learning. And he's actually talking about training departments, but he says training departments look at formal learning much more than where most people are, where they look at informal learning. And I think the same sort of thing is probably true where universities are in terms of learning, how most people encounter learning has already moved online, away from the lecture hall or whatever you think it should be. But the other thing is whether the student experience is about the learning anyway. Maybe it's about something else. There's, if you look on Twitter, there's quite a lot of discussion about that as well. So we'll come back to these sorts of things, possibly as drama. This CD walk idea that I was talking to Chris about is just a way of asking a question, how much space is needed for education, by comparing it with record stores. So that a lot of this will just turn into fiction of some sort or another.